the Dick Dancer Dancers. And now, from their high-res studios in La Hermitage, here's that white guy, Bruce Williams.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. We're remote this week from
Ooltewah, Tennessee,
right outside of Chattanooga, very near the Adventist University.
It's the Cherokee word for sitting on your car keys. Ooltewah!
And our co-host, of course, the lovely John Pate, who is a recent resident of Ooltewah.
Yes. There's the delay. The audience is sitting so far away.
Yes.
Yeah,
the sound is coming in.
Because we have such a huge suite here at the Holiday Inn.
That's right. And we've actually doubled our audience this week.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. From the last time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you got I think we have three.
We have three watchers. And size doesn't matter, as Donald Trump always said. But tonight it's going to be an abbreviated show because
I'm sitting on my foot, and when my foot goes to sleep, the show's over.
It's time. Yeah. That's a timer.
That's right.
A body timer that John has always had.
Exactly.
And he uses that when he's at concerts and stuff, you know, when that foot goes to sleep.
It's over.
Yeah. It's get up time. Yeah. Yeah.
And then this episode is brought to you by Dasani Water and by Vivian, the hotel room attendant.
That's right. Now, Vivian also does room 108,
yes,
which is right across from our room.
And if they happen to be watching, they're going to be in for a big surprise. So welcome.
Dasani water is made by Coca-Cola, and who knows more about pure water than Coca-Cola?
That's all I'm saying.
Yeah. That's right. So would you hand me my booklet over there in my bag?
Yes, because this is a highly scripted show.
Yes.
Highly scripted, and as the tens of people who are tuning in right now will tell you, the quality of this show, we spare no expense. And I mean no expense.
Yes.
In bringing you this show.
Right. What I wanted to talk about is the vaccines. Now, hopefully, we are in line to get a vaccine. Are you in line to get a vaccine? We hope you are. Or you may be one of those people who won't get the vaccine because you don't want the vaccine. Some people call those anti-vaxxers, but I prefer to call them
people...
Deceased. Exactly. And we have choices now with the vaccine. Sometimes you don't always get a choice because the early ones, you know, whatever one comes up.
Right.
You know, but there is the AstraZeneca.
There's a variety.
Yeah. There's a variety of vaccines, a V. And AstraZeneca is one of them.
AstraZeneca, yeah.
And they also make Nexium. So I was wondering why you couldn't combine the COVID vaccine with Nexium. And that way it would take care of any acid reflux you might have.
Baked beans for hours.
you can eat baked beans, and or you could, you know, if it's one of those where you have to get the booster shot 10 days later, then daughter. Hi Keely. And she's saying hi, John. We were just
Hi Keely.
We were just talking about you, Keely, at dinner when you used to come in the dressing room at the cooking show and you do your high drama.
And it was impressive.
Mm-hmm.
It was very impressive.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those were great memories.
Yes. And now that that torch has been handed off to our other granddaughter, Pepper. She is now the drama queen of our family. And so we were talking about the vaccines and the combining them, you know. Oh, there's Kevin Phillips.
What do you say?
Kevin Phillips, we should call him. He's probably got a great parody that he can do for us. He's always doing tremendous parodies, like on the spot. He almost makes them up on the spot. It's just an incredible talent that he has. I hope our sound is okay. It looks like it's working.
Apparently it's working because people are responding.
So. Okay. The other was Pfizer. Pfizer is the other vaccine.
And they offer smooth or chunky. Now that needle, the chunky is hard to handle. So.
Yeah. And Pfizer also makes Viagra. So I was wondering why they couldn't combine the Viagra and the vaccine. And hopefully both the vaccine and the Viagra would be long lasting. Unless you're married, and then your wife would say, I hope that goes away soon.
I'm trying to find Kevin Phillips.
Okay.
But I can't find his on my messages.
I don't know if we sent him a link.
I know I have. I just copied the link. I just need to find an email.
Oh, by the way, that's our producer off screen.
Yeah, that's Sharon Hollingdahl Williams. She's our producer and our engineer. When Terry's not here with his engineers.
Now we are coming to you from Ultawa, and this evening it's a little bit rainy, so the weather here, and it may turn to snow before tomorrow.
It did turn to snow coming over the pass, over Mont Eagle.
Yes.
Yes, there was quite a bit of snow. It was a winter wonderland.
Oh.
Yes. And but no accumulation on the road.
Oh, good.
Yeah, just in the woods. It looked like the sequel to the Blair Witch Project, which was filmed during the winter, and most of the cast died. You heard about the guy who went to the drive-in movie and died?
No.
Because he went to see closed for the winter? Oh!
Hey!
Oh!
We'll be here all week.
The vaccine, will the vaccine work? Will it help with dementia? Will it help with my early onset dementia?
Oh, your early onset dementia.
Yeah.
Who are you again?
My gosh, it's contagious.
It's the virulent strain, yes.
Uh-huh. Does it matter which vaccine I get?
Well, it depends on whether you have the British strain or just the regular.
Oh, the British strain. Yes.
Well, the British strain, I think, they say just simply makes your teeth look bad.
Of course it does. Should I get all three?
All three vaccines?
Yeah. Oh. AstraZeneca, Pfizer, and Johnson & Johnson. They have a vaccine. Johnson & Johnson has a vaccine, and they always put a little baby powder where you're going to get the shot and stuff to kind of numb that area. Numb, 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 numb.
Is this Kevin Phillips, the Cowboy Radio?
Yes.
Could be.
Awesome.
That's him.
Well, while you're waiting, mm-hmm. And speaking of Great Britain, I believe that a call is coming in from the Queen. If you care to interview the Queen about this entire debacle. So you take the call, and I'll just read the book over here, if that's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Okay. The Queen has called in. The Queen of England has
called in. Hello! How are you?
I'm good.
Is this Bruce?
Yes, it's Bruce Williams.
Hello, Bruce.
Yes.
Yes.
Your Majesty, I see you're wearing a plaid again, which...
Yes, I'm wearing plaid. It's my plaid royal robe.
And, of course, plaid being the Scottish...
Yes, of course. You know, not only am I Queen of England, I'm also Queen of Scotland, too. And Wales!
And Wales,
Wales, yes!
And dolphins, yes.
Did you get her on the phone?
I got her.
Okay, I'm just
going
to turn the page. Okay. Read this next page.
Okay.
Just go ahead with you.
All right, the queen is still on the line.
Yes, indeed, I'm still here.
Yes, queen.
where is your partner this evening?
The big Indian?
You know I like him.
Yes.
Yes, he's very, very funny.
Yes, he is rather humorous.
Yes, of course.
I'm going to have to get some water
because I swallowed that.
Okay, so. I'm going to add your guest.
Okay. Hello, please ask.
Okay, here's our guest. The Queen will be talking to Kevin Phillips.
Why are you dark? Why are you dark, Kevin?
Why is Kevin dark? This doesn't look dark.
I know, because I see him.
Mm-hmm.
Are you finished with me?
No.
No, you're not finished with me.
We're not finished with you, Queen.
Okay.
Okay.
Very well, I'll be here.
Yes.
Having a bonbon.
Can you tell us about the new strain of COVID over in England?
Yes, of course.
Is it bad?
It's terrible. It's putting a strain on us. Little royal humor there.
And, Your Majesty, I've noticed that lately England has been looking at America and what's going on here. And do you ever worry about your own security?
No, I don't worry about it at all. Because I just simply post Charles at the door. And of course, Charles standing there is enough to scare away any protesters.
You mean his face drives them away?
Yes, of course. It's like, I don't like his face.
Would you say that Camilla Parker Bowles?
Oh dear! It even scared me when you said that.
Did you know Camilla Parker Bowles?
Yes, of course I do. Yes, you said it again.
Did you know? Camilla Parker also plays tennis?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes, but mostly Camilla Parker Bowles.
You know, I really have a lot of royal business to take care of, if it's okay with you.
Well, it is okay with me, but we're not, our other guest, Kevin Phillips, isn't on yet. So,
oh, he's not on yet?
So we need you to fill some more time.
No. I'll be here for a few more minutes.
Okay, he's here. He's here now.
Yes.
Let's hear the queen.
Well, thank you very much.
Let's hear it for the queen. Some
applause. Thank you. I would love to talk to you later. Thank you very much. I'm signing off now.
That was the queen of England.
Okay. How did that interview go? I was reading the book.
It went pretty well.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Hi, Kevin.
Hi, fellas.
We're here in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and we were hoping that maybe you had one of your wonderful parodies.
I don't know, but I can make one.
No pressure.
Pick a topic.
Whoa. Hey. You got grandkids.
Hey. I do. We're watching Scooby-Doo.
You're watching Scooby-Doo? Right, right, Revan.
Zoinks!
Zoinks! Revan?
We were wondering if you had a few bars of the impeachment blues.
The impeachment blues?
Yes.
Hmm. Well, I think so. Let's see. Okay. No.
No.
Oh, he's got nothing.
Hey, well, don't make me have to call the queen back.
Impeachment blues, huh?
Yeah, anything, any one of your latest ones, if you can remember it.
Well, I just wrote one today and recorded it, but I'm saving it for Inauguration Day.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh. Oh, yeah, you wouldn't want to put it on our show because really it would really blast out to so many people.
Hey, we want to sing?
Sixth Amendment dreams?
Does she want to sing one?
Yeah.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Yeah, we like that one.
How I wonder.
Why is he what?
I keep popping pills.
Don't know.
Why is he in poppy fields?
Is that a joke? Is that a riddle?
Oh, grandkids, great. Oh, man.
Do you know any good riddles?
I don't remember what the song was. They did a Biden parody too. Had something to do with him taking over and the other guy leaving or not leaving.
Uh huh. Jeez. Yeah.
That's rather timely too.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah, I wish I could remember.
You got a mind like one of those big gray things with the floppy ears. And a memory. You have a memory like one of those. You know, Kevin, as we age, our minds become less sharp. That's where Prevagen can help. Prevagen uses a secret ingredient found in jellyfish.
That's why jellyfish have such a great memory.
Yes. If you ask a jellyfish what happened yesterday, he'll be able to tell you.
Oh. I wish I had prepared for my ad-libs.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Me too.
Popping me.
Copying you.
Avery.
Oh, because the phone's echoing, so she thinks you're copying me.
Oh, Avery, would you sing us a song?
Do it. You can do it. What should we sing? Helter Skelter?
I know that's one of my grandkids' favorite songs. sing the theme song from Scooby Doo.
No.
That's all right, Ravery.
I think Wheels on the Bus.
She said that for free.
Our producer thinks Wheels on the Bus.
Wheels on the bus. Can we sing it?
No.
Ready?
No.
Wheels on the bus.
No. Okay, that's a hard no.
Oh, suddenly she's gone all Taylor Swift on us.
You gotta get the picture for your laugh.
How about the cleanup song?
Clean up.
That's all I know.
That's it? That's all you know?
Hey, sing the Ding Dong song.
No.
I actually played... What did they play for you guys this morning? Since I've had the COVID, memories at a loss.
Oh? You had the COVID?
Yeah.
Yeah, we talked about that last time.
You see, Bruce can't remember things. So.
I can't. Yeah, I forget to take my Prevagen.
I lost my cell phone the other day. That was exciting. Which reminds me, I need you to message me your phone number because I lost it.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
All right.
Did you ever have any other symptoms besides...
No. Little cough, lost taste, or lost my smell for 3 days.
Yeah.
And lost your memory.
They're talking about some people that that don't have their taste back after 6-8 weeks, you know?
Yeah.
You want to be in the picture?
There she is.
There, how's that?
Do you know the fruit salad song?
I know. No, she never got into the Wiggles.
Oh.
Oh.
I do, though.
We've been big into the Wiggles.
Fruit salad.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
You don't like that one?
No. Sugar gun. Oh, look at that. She has
her
dad's boot.
Oh, wow.
It's an adventure.
I got my Stranger Things socks on.
I've got my 2001 shirt on. It's the back it says, it's Rock Sturgis Bowl. And it's Elvis' birthday.
2001?
No, I got the shirt in
2000. I hope you've watched
Sturgis.
It. Oh, the Sturgis shirt. Okay.
Sturgis shirt.
We're missing every other word. Back. So.
And what year did you get that shirt?
2001.
Wow.
It's the only Sturgis shirt I have.
That was 19 years before COVID.
Yep.
Yeah.
And I have I'm wearing a Sturgis thong, but it didn't start off as a thong. It is now.
Yeah, that's like our T-shirts that we sell and stuff. Most of them have disintegrated, but every once in a while somebody says, do you make any more of these T-shirts? And, no.
The Elvis one, I don't know where they got it. Whoa!
Okay.
Did she fall and hit her head?
She fell off of a bouncy ball.
Uh-oh. Well, that's you know, Sharon and I got this new mirror thing. It's a workout thing. It's a mirror, and then you can work out with these instructors and stuff, and take dance classes and yoga classes and relaxation classes and stuff. It's really, really pretty neat. And last night we did a dance class. And boy, it looked like the COVID ward at the old folks' home. I mean, I got no moves, I got no game, and stuff. It's tough for me to even shift my weight, you know.
Oh, you're shifting great.
Oh yeah, but my weight is doing a lot of reaching like this and stuff. That's harder than you think when you get old. You know, that's why there's chair yoga.
The closest I've got is Barker Lounger yoga.
Barker Lounger.
Yeah.
Barker Lounger.
You know, Bob Barker Lounger's around here.
That's the one.
Bob Barker Lounger.
There's somebody that went to Sturgis. 1985.
Yes, 1985 was a great year to be at Sturgis. That was back when they still had motorcycle races.
Well, they still do. They're more politically correct.
Yeah. But remember across the interstate there was that little track and stuff? That was pretty much the whole deal, you know.
Yeah. When I first moved here from Minnesota.
Yeah.
I went up to Spearfish to do a radio broadcast.
And I saw the short track, and I said, who are the idiots that put the light poles in the middle of the hockey rink? Oh, sorry.
What'd she say?
She's not in the picture. There you go.
There you go. Hi. Hi, Avery.
Say hi, Bruce.
Avery, would you come to Nashville, Tennessee and sing on the Grand Ole Opry?
Heck yeah. I would.
Okay. Well, then Grandpa can come and be on the Grand Ole Opry.
I'd love that.
Yeah.
I would do a parody.
If you could. Yeah. You'll have one written especially for it, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Hey, did you see Ed Bruce died today?
I did. 81? Yeah.
He was awesome.
Yeah, and he played a role on Maverick.
He sang the theme.
He did?
Maverick didn't lose. Yeah, that was Ed Bruce.
I did not know
and
that.
And he also wrote Mama Baby's Drunken Cowboys.
He did?
I believe so.
Wow.
No.
I was introduced to a guy named Ed once, and they said, Ed Bruce. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And since there's a thing called ED, we do apologize to anyone named Ed.
Ed Lives Matter.
Ed Lives Matter. All right, we got to let you go, Kevin. Enjoy your time with your.
I can leave you with an old classic.
Okay.
You want to be in the picture? Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
Out in the western South Dakota town of Deadwood. I played blackjack with my friends. Got into a whoop with a little old lady. He hit my face when I cut my chin. That's all.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah. Splitting tens.
The applause is coming in from the audience right now. There it is. Ah.
Thank you, Kevin.
I should do Elvis too because it's Elvis' birthday.
Okay. All right, Kevin. Take care, bud.
Bye-bye.
So long.
See you next time. See you soon, I hope. Well, there we go.
Why is he still there?
Well, I don't know, but you'll be able to figure that out.
Oops, no.
Oh, there we go. Utawa.
Are we back on the script?
Yes, we're back to our script.
Okay.
I got nothing. I got nothing.
Some friends checking in here. You got Rebecca.
Oh my goodness.
Rebecca May Lawless says hi.
Oh, Rebecca May Lawless. Yeah. She has a great show. She has a great online show. And she does.
Hello, Rebecca.
She has music and she has. She does like handyman things, you know, where she shows you how to fix a leaky faucet and stuff. And
really?
Yeah. Yeah. And it's very educational what she does. And she's a great singer, you know. Her late husband, Jack Lawless, was an integral part of their duo. And they've been... they're all over the place on social media and all that. And God bless Jack. He was a wonderful, wonderful guy. And we sure miss him. And we wish Rebecca May all the best luck in the world with her program because it's well worth watching. She may even put it up where to contact her. On her message there. Is that it? Yeah, I'm going to be on February 4th. I'm going to be on her show.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Yeah.
Are you going to do that hedgehog juggling routine that you guys used to do?
No, because the two hedgehogs that we had trained for that whole bit, one of them died, and the other one just refused to work anymore because
We got an agent, William Morris, and so
he did.
That was probably
he got the got issue. The William Morris agent, and the William Morris agent said, "I can get you on Sonic the Hedgehog, the movie."
Oh well, then
and then he went and tried out. And
can't compete with
him. And his voice was too high; he just couldn't.
I think she's double checking that you're actually going to do the show on.
Oh. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I literally have nothing to do, as you can see, Rebecca May. So there's no time constraints or me saying, I can't be there unless I get COVID. Yeah. If I get COVID, then I'm not coming. But that's the only thing. And I might have COVID hair. Look at that.
Oh, I should be doing something.
Oh, there we go.
Hey, it's great to be here in Chattanooga.
That's a great Nancy Pelosi impression.
What did you say about her? She was
standing in front of the mirror, and she said to her husband, "You know, I'm getting all of these wrinkles. My hair's turning gray, and my skin is sagging a little bit. I need you to pay me a compliment." And her husband said, "Well, your eyesight's pretty near perfect."
Oh.
Well, there we go.
Yeah, sorry. I'm always off.
Well, you know, my foot is almost asleep.
Okay,
so
okay.
I believe that.
I think we've been running long enough.
We've exhausted this.
We have run out of material, but...
Well, and you can't call the queen back. She's very busy.
So. Right. Now, Sarah, did you want to do an opinion piece?
No, I'm good. I don't have that many strong opinions. I have only weak opinions.
I think your wife is brilliant.
She is. She is the perfect wife.
The perfect wife, yeah.
Perfect wife, yes. She's tall, blonde, beautiful, intelligent, funny, mm-hmm. and has no sense of smell.
But that's not associated with COVID.
Not associated with COVID.
That was pre-COVID. Right?
Yes. Yeah. Are you saying that you have
a sense of
smell? Are you odoriferous?
Well, I occasionally, yeah. It just mm-hmm. depends on. Depends on what I eat, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I really wouldn't be able to tell if I had COVID or not because I've never had any taste. So. I mean, look at the way I'm dressed.
Yes.
The queen's plaid.
Yes.
You're wearing the queen's plaid.
How tacky can
you be? Come here, Tonka.
Nobody's ever seen Tonka.
You know, this is... One of the reasons for the trip is that Bruce is picking up a lovely little companion dog. Not this one, but a companion for... Oh, and there's Percy right over
Percy,
there.
Percy,
and Percy over
yes.
here.
Okay.
Yes. Because we got to get some camera time.
Yeah.
Here we
okay,
go.
Okay, this is Tonka. She never gets any camera time. Right. Percy gets all the camera
Percy's
time.
Percy's gotten the camera time, too.
Yeah. So Tonka is our... old dowager dog.
Yeah.
She's what, 14? 13?
Oh my goodness.
And Percy's two?
Two and a half.
Two and a half. And we're going to go pick up another Yorkie like Percy, tricolored Yorkie in Cumming, Georgia. And we're going to bring him home with us tomorrow. So.
Well,
that's why we are doing the remote from Chattanooga. So we're going to have to get up and, oh, thank you for the kisses, Tonka. Oh, you're such a good girl. Yes, you are. Tonka is a Brussels Griffon. I always thought it was a Brussels Griffin, but she's a Brussels Griffon. If you saw the movie As Good As It Gets with Jack Nicholson and Helen Hunt, the dog in there that was named Verdell was a Brussels Griffon like Tonka. And of course, it was an OCD dog, and Tonka is a little bit OCD, aren't you? Yeah, you are. And if you saw that movie, also, the dog's name was Verdell, which happens to be the real name of my partner, Terry Ree. His real name is Verdell. I'm just throwing that out there.
The secret is... So all of you, the next concert, wear your Verdell t-shirts.
Yes. Hi, Verdell. Just say hi, Verdell. And so that does it for our broadcast. I would like to thank our special guest host, John Pate. And we'd like to thank you for tuning in, because
without you... And I'm about to click something that says credits, but I'm not sure that it is.
Oh, wait, we forgot to show the pictures. We got to show the pictures. Right. Now, your wife, Sarah, took pictures on your vacation down to Punta Cana, Dominican Republic.
Dominican Republic. And it was an adventure.
Yeah, and here's one she took of a sign, and it's a really low sign, and it says in Spanish, piso, what does it say? Piso.
Resbaladizo.
Which I believe is slippery.
Caution, there's a slippery floor.
But if you notice, it's 4 inches above the floor. Mm-hmm. So you can only read it after you've fallen down.
It's like, oh, thanks for telling me.
Oh, that's it. Good thing that you just, yes. Thank you for the sign.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
I would have been laying here not knowing what happened.
Now it's perfectly clear why I have a concussion. The floor was slippery.
And then she took a picture of a person doing
beach yoga.
Beach lounge yoga.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
That is attractive in any country.
We don't allow nudity on the show, but this is pretty damn close. No. I'll tell you what.
Let's just say it was windy that day. The blower completely backward. Happened to catch the moment.
That's a that's a variation of the downward facing dog, isn't it, Tonka? Yes.
Oh, did you hear that growl?
Yeah. It's like, don't.
Let it go there, Tonka.
Yeah. That's right.
So that essentially was the entire vacation.
I love the Dominican Republic. It's got some wonderful resorts down there, and
beautiful.
I'm a big fan.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I wish we were there right now. Let's do that next time. Let's do a remote.
Next remote from Dominican Republic.
Yes. Punta Cana.
Well, thank you for tuning in.
Yes, and don't forget to buy Williams and Ree merchandise, because that's the only income we have. And as you can tell, the production is costly on these production videos.
That's right. This
water. $3. $3
for that.
At the desk and stuff. And that's if you're a member of the Holiday Inn.
The paper for these cards doesn't grow on trees.
Exactly. We love you, everybody. Take care.
Until next time.
Bunch, and I've just now started to include the song that I sang on that show in my act.
To see what was on.
Yeah, this Nashville Network.
We were flipping channels. We don't watch your stuff.
So you don't watch the Nashville Network?
No!
We just told you we don't.
Well, how come it's on now?
We were flipping channels. We do not watch this stuff, I'm telling you. We don't, I don't know what's
going on. Is this a picture of Ralph Emery?
That's my wife's picture. I'm going to get rid of
that. Well, the t-shirt's in the doll. Okay, you caught us. This is our stuff, and we watch this network, and I got to admit it.
Oh, great. Not only are you watching it, but you're taping it for other people to watch?
Yes. I told you. I'm tired of the running. I'm tired of the secrecy, the sneaking around. I've got to admit it. I'm a TNN. junkie.
Now, look what you've done. He's a nervous wreck. All he ever wanted to do was watch TNN.
I didn't want to hurt him.